Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas and here we have one more challenge rift. This time we get to play with the Crusader class once again, and here we have this build. This build plays only with legendary items. There is not even the Legacy of Nightmares set here within this build. So this is something like a troll build. Some of the items are bad selections. It is not a complete a build that makes too much sense, but anyway, it can do its job. So this build plays with Adarius Visage without a gem in the socket, Spolders of Zakar, Mantle of the Retrialm, Eye of Etlitz without any legendary gem or any other gem in the socket, Strong Arm Brazers, a primal item, but it doesn't matter, really. String of Fears, Gloves of Worship, Rachel's Ring of Larceny. Yeah, primal item without any gem in the socket. Avarice Bud, without any gem in the socket. It has no socket after all. Skeleton's Deceit, Illusory Boots, Frideir's Wrath, and the Furnace. At least this one has an emerald gem in the socket. And this one also has a gem in the socket. So, the canine skill powers of this build are Blade of Prophecy for the Condemned skill, Leoric's Crown. Unfortunately, there is no gem here in the socket, so this power here is useless, 100% useless. And here we have the Convention of Elements. Thank the gods of Sanctuary. This thing is very nice here, it works. It is not useless like this one. The skills this build is using are Slash with the Rune Guard, Provoke with Too Scared to Run, Condemn with Vacuum, Iron Skin with Steel Skin, Loss of Valor with Unstoppable Force, and Akarat's Champion with the Prophet. The passive skills are Heavenly Strength, Indestructible, Holy Cause, and Definary. So, this is the build. This is not a very good build. There are many items and things that are not good here in this build, but anyway, it can still work. This is a Condemned build, meaning that it deals damage with the Condemned skill, this one here. Now, if you are new to Crusader class or Diablo 3 overall, you don't know how to play this build. This build is challenging, it is not an easy build, but it is not that hard either. It is a simple build to play, but you have to be patient until you understand exactly what to do and when to do it. So, this is how we play. First of all, when we go inside the rift, we use all the time the slash skill, because this one increases our armor, not for the damage it deals, but it increases our armor. Of course, it also generates some wrath per attack, which is not that much actually, but anyway, it helps. But we use it because we need to stack it to 5 stacks, because we want to get more armor. It helps with survivability. This is a fragile build, so we use it against enemies. Also, we don't have a great attacking speed, so we have to be careful and to use it and get more armor. We try to have this active all the time inside the rift. The second thing is that we use Iron Skin when this one helps absorbing all damage, incoming damage, for 7 seconds, and it has a cooldown of 30 seconds. So, when you fight some tough situations, you activate this skill here to get more toughness and survive also. The Akarat Champion increases both survivability and damage output, and also the wrath regeneration. So this one is better to use when you fight against elite packs, while there are also many small enemies around. So when you do big battles, because this is the best time to use this skill. We want loss of valor to activate, because this one reduces the wrath cost of all of our skills, meaning the condemned skill also, because this skill costs wrath by using this seed. It has no cooldown, but it costs 40 wrath. Now, if we have this one active, it reduces the cost wrath of the skill of all of our skills by 50%. So every time we cast it, it costs only 20 wrath while this one is active. So you have to remember this and try to activate this skill in the right time so you get back wrath. Also, of course, it gives you attack speed, which means that when you have increased attack speed, you can use the slash skill faster against enemies and increase your toughness and armor even faster. So it helps also with this skill, the attack speed of this one with this skill. Now, when you are inside the rift and you have used most of your wrath, and you see plenty many enemies in an area, you go to this area and you use the provoke skill. This one taunts enemies, makes enemies come and attack you, but also it gives you back 5 wrath for every enemy taunted, which means if you are out of wrath and there are 5 enemies here and you use the taunt skill, you will get back instantly 25 wrath points. Because 5 per enemy, 5 enemies, 5 times 5, 25. So you have to remember that this is a way to get back, to generate some wrath, because you want to generate wrath, to have wrath, to be using it all the time with the condemned skill. Now, when it comes to this skill is the only skill that deals damage, true damage, with this build. This skill works like this. We activate the skill for 3 seconds, it builds up, and then it sucks in enemies, as it says here. It pulls enemies closer to you, and then some beams come down from the sky and hit enemies. This is a condemned skill. So this skill also has a 3 seconds charge up, which means you activate it and after 3 seconds it will do damage, but for 3 seconds it builds up, it pulls in enemies, and after 3 seconds it deals damage with the beams. You have to remember this 3 seconds period, because for example, if you are here and you see down there some elite packs, one elite pack let's say, when you go run towards the elite pack, you activate it now, it charges up, it builds, and when you reach the elite, it the beam comes down, it hits the elite, it kills it. So you have to somewhat synchronize the charge up, the build up of this skill, the condemn, when to hit the skill to activate it, when how long it will take to reach your elite packs, your enemies, for this skill to hit at the right time, and all of these things. It is not a hard thing to do, but you just have to get used to how this skill works. And also, since this skill has no cooldowns now because of the shield, it has no cooldowns, we can hit it and hit it again and hit it again. So as we can see, we get more beams, but of course the more times you hit the skill, the more wrath you lose, so you have to be careful. For example, now let's say here there is an elite pack and there are 20 more small enemies. So if we want to deal damage to all of them, the best thing is while we are going there to hit our condemned skill 2 or 3 times. So when we reach our enemies, more beams will come down at almost the same time, one after another, and this way we will kill faster all of these enemies. So this is it. It is simple enough. It is not complicated. You just have to get used a little bit. And also you have to see The best time actually to use, for example, this skill, Provoke, is to use it when there are many enemies around. If you use it against one or two enemies to gain back wrath, it will be wasted. Just wait until you fight at least 5 or maybe 10 enemies, use it, so you can get wrath from as many enemies as possible, to fill your wrath bar as fast as possible. So this is it, guys. I hope it makes sense. This is not an easy build, but this is not a complicated build. It is simple enough, and it is not that hard. Actually, it is a challenging build, but not that hard. I am sure that you can do it even if you are a new player to the game. Just be a little bit patient. Check out the maps. The map of the floors of this rift is in the beginning of this video, of course. And you have to remember where are the elites and many enemies together. You go there, kill them all, synchronize a little bit your condemned skill. And try to use your skills in the correct times. And if you do that, you will be successful. So thanks for watching. Now you will see if you won't stay in this video and watch my performance. I completed successfully this rift in my second attempt, and yeah, it was a hard thing to do, but you have to be careful. And I will see you with more videos in the future. Bye for now and good luck.
I wish I could do that. bleeding.
Steadfast.